Katherine, and I am back with another video, and it is, of course, Riverdale themed again. Finally, I am doing my Betty Cooper hair, makeup, and outfit look, and I have actually done these videos for the two other main girls in this show, Cheryl Blossom and Veronica Lodge. If you want to check out those videos, they will be linked right... See, I always do the wrong side, so I think it's this side. They will be linked right here. And also in the description box. And yeah, so before I get into the video, I also want to make a really quick announcement and thank you guys so much for 100 subscribers. I know it's not a lot compared to people who have like a million followers, but I have had this channel for lots of years now, and I have been trying to create content that people liked, and I'm really happy that I'm able to share it with 100 people. I mean, that just sounds like a crazy amount of people to me, and stay tuned for another really...
Why do I look like that meme with the Italian people? Like, what?
Really exciting video that's coming up. You will not want to miss it. If you guys are not already subscribed, make sure you subscribe down below and click that little bell icon if you want to get notified and when I upload new videos, which you definitely will want. There is a bug on my camera. So there's tons of exciting new things that are coming out that you're definitely not going to want to miss, so make sure that you turn on my notifications and let's get into the video. So Betty Cooper has a very natural glow to her, and I just love that about her because unlike Veronica and Cheryl, although their looks are just absolutely stunning, Betty can somehow pull off being super fresh-faced and almost the no makeup makeup look. So that's kind of what we're going to be trying to achieve in this video. I'm not going to be putting on a lot of makeup at all, so this look is going to be super simple but still super Betty. I'm going to be starting off with some primer because it's just so important to prime your face before you put any makeup on it. And I am using my fave, the e.l.f. Hydrating Face Primer, all over my face. So I'm starting off with the BB cream, and I'm just doing a light layer of this all over my face just to kind of even out my skin tone because Betty Cooper does have somehow like perfect skin, so we're gonna try to mimic that without, you know, caking our face. Next, I'm going to be taking my favorite concealer ever, which is the Tarte Shape Tape Concealer, and just concealing places that I feel like need to be concealed. I'm not going to go too overboard with this. Definitely my under eyes are going to need concealer and a couple imperfections. And then I'm going to go ahead and blend that in. Next, I'm going to be setting my under eyes with some of this Sephora powder. Because when you're using a cream product, you definitely want to set it, especially it's summer and it's hot and I feel like I'm already sweating all of this off. So, next we are going to be skipping the harsh bronzer and going straight for a really nice light blush. So this blush palette, it's like dying, but this color is definitely a Betty Cooper color. It's light and it's not anything that's going to be too out there, but it's definitely still going to give us that nice cheekbone glow that we want. I'm just going to go ahead and take that onto a brush, and I'm going to be putting it on the apples of my cheeks and blending up. Next, Betty just has this just glow to her face, so we're going to be using highlighter, and I'm just going to be going on my cheekbones. So we have completed Betty Cooper's face. I feel like this is very Betty Cooper. And now we are going to be moving on to lips. I have this pink lip crayon and I'm just going to be applying that all over my lips. And then I'm going to be using this lighter pink lip gloss, which is from Smashbox, and going over it. And those are Betty Cooper's iconic pink lips. And now we'll move on to eyes. So, again, I never do anything on my eyes without priming my lids first. This is the Urban Decay Eyeshadow Primer Potion. And I'm going to be using my favorite Naked 2 Basics palette. And starting off with the lightest colors in this palette, I'm just going to apply them all over my lids. Next, I'm going to take this third color. I'm going to put that color on the outer edge of my lid. And then I'm just going to go ahead and blend that in. And seriously, you guys, we're almost done. How easy is that? I'm just going to be taking a mix of the two darkest colors, and I'm going to be lining across my lid, but only on like the outer half. And yeah, that's Betty Cooper's completed eye look. It's super simple and super casual because Betty, seriously, she like just looks like she's naturally gorgeous and doesn't have to put on makeup at all. But obviously we see that smoky eye Betty, so we just wanted to give just like a very natural take on a smoky eye because that's what Betty does. And then finally, to complete the look, I am using some mascara on just my upper lashes. Finally, the last part of this look is eyebrows, and I'm just going to be going and combing through my eyebrows, and I'm not even going to fill them in because I feel like her eyebrows are kind of the same as mine, but if you have lighter eyebrows, you might want to fill them in. She's blonde, so her eyebrows are kind of like a lightish brown color, which is kind of what mine are, so you know, that is really the completed look. It was so simple to do, and I really love that. So Betty's look is about creating a super fresh face of makeup without, you know, spending a lot of time on creating the perfect look. I do love the other girls' iconic looks in Riverdale. Obviously, I mean, I recreated them, but I wanted to pay homage to one of my favorite characters, who I say for every single character, but seriously, I love Betty. Honestly, I would redo this makeup look, like, if I was, like, going somewhere and I didn't have a lot of time to get ready, since this did not take me very long at all. So let's just move on to the hair. So we all know Betty's iconic ponytail look, so we're gonna go ahead and try to recreate that, which I think will be super easy to do. So first, I'm just gonna put my hair up in a ponytail. You can use like a regular hairband because I feel like that's what Betty like uses, but I'm using a pink scrunchie because I love scrunchies, they're kind of my thing, and also, obviously, it's pink, it's Betty Cooper. So we have our hang pony, and you want it to be, like, super tight, because that's how Betty has her hair just, like, slicked back. Sometimes I will pull down some strands of hair to frame my face, if you want to do that, but I'm going to be keeping it exactly how Betty has her hair. And now I'm going to be taking my curling iron. Oh, it's hot. I don't know why I just touched it. Good job. And I'm going to be curling sections of the ponytail. Now, if you guys want to curl your hair and then put it in a ponytail, that would probably work too. I just felt like it was easier to put all of my hair up into one spot and then curl it from there, but I feel like it'll work either way. So this is the finished hair, and I feel like this is pretty great. I mean, it's super simple to recreate, as we found out most of the Riverdale hairstyles are to do, but I really like this one actually. And if you guys want to see the outfit, just keep watching because I'm about to show you. I can't get enough of myself.